All right, what do we got? It's a scorpion. Okay. I can't remember playing this set, but I have been studying the matchup a little bit against Scorpion because Scorpion is a problem character for me, so I'm a bit more familiar now with his strings and his frame data than what I was during this set. So, kind of just going to talk about that, I guess, while we watch the gameplay. Ooh, that's the overhead. That's the 1-2-2, I believe. It's minus 3 on block, but there's a gap in between the first two and the second two, and you can armor through that, I believe. I think you can also up block that. I really, really need to start using up block because a lot of the overheads in this game are actually safe. So if you don't up block them, you just have to kind of engage in down one RPS after blocking them. So I definitely need to start using that a bit more. That was terrible. Luckily, oh god, he did it again. Luckily, he didn't punish it too badly. I think the forward two overhead of General Shao is a minus 37 or something. So if you block it, you get absolutely monumental punishes. Scorpion, with the right cameo assist, he can get like 45-50% for blocking it. So it's really risky. But I do have Mataro, so the risk reward isn't terrible because I can combo from it. Ooh. Right, that right there, I think that's his forward 3-2 string, the knee into the uppercut punch. It's minus 6 on block, so it's completely safe. You can't, like, down one him and take your turn back. But the second hit, the 2, is the uppercut punch, and it's a high, so you can duck it and then punish. Which kind of forces Scorpion to play kind of a, like, reset, like, mix-up stuff with the forward 3, which is only minus 4 on block, so he can do, like, forward 3 into down 1, forward 3 into throw, forward 3 into backdash, into button, stuff like that. If he thinks you're going to, you know, try and crouch block the 2 follow-up, he can do kind of weird stuff like that, but I'm not blocking it. I'm not ducking it too much right now in this set, so he doesn't really need to do that. Yeah, that law. That law's pretty good. It has, like, really, really good range on it. His back 3, I believe. But at close ranges like that, it's monumentally unsafe, so the Scorpions shouldn't really be doing that. I mean, I'm not Scorpion main, so I'm not going to tell him how to play the character, but up close like that, it's really minus. But if he spaces it correctly, it's safe, and yeah, that's pretty good. Scorpion, I think. That's what a lot of Scorpion players do to me right now. It's kind of they backwalk into spear, trying to, you know, just land free spears and get full combos, or they backwalk into back 3 for the low, and then sometimes they'll do the backwalk into the enhanced teleport, stuff like that. Basically, they just walk away from me and then try and do stuff like that and just kind of whittle my health bar down and use the spear for big combos. But other than that, he doesn't really have too much from what I found out researching the character and like labbing him a little bit. He doesn't really have too many good block strings. Most of his buttons are high. He doesn't really have good overhead mix, so he feels like for me, at my current skill level, he's a problem because I'm not ducking spear consistently and I'm not ducking that consistently and I keep getting hit by the sweep, but against like better players, I would assume he has like a really hard time opening people up. He doesn't seem to be like a counter zoner or a zoner himself. He's kind of weird, like a neutral footsies whiff punish orientated character, which I don't think is too strong right now in Mortal Kombat 1, so at low levels, I think he's kind of cheap and he's quite easy to get wins with, but I think he kind of falls off a bit as he starts to get a bit stronger. I've noticed myself, as I've like learned the matchup, I've played Scorpion since this set, and you know, I've implemented some of the knowledge I've gained fighting him, and he's definitely become a lot easier to fight. He's still a problem character because, you know, I'm not very good, but as I grow and get better as a player, I think he's gonna not be too much of a problem. One of the annoying things for me though, just fighting Scorpion, is that if I run like a Mataro or you know, like a Kung Lao, it's very difficult to punish him from just like full range, like full screen, or you know, like three quarter screen for throwing out spear. You can't really do it too well. Oh, look, he didn't punish that. Thankfully for me, this Scorpion doesn't seem to know the matchup either, so he's letting me get away with using very punishable buttons that I shouldn't really be doing as much as I am. But yeah, I have given Frost a go. I don't know if I'll be using Frost in the next video or the video after that, but Frost seems like a pretty damn good character, because if you duck spear, you just do forward cameo assist, freeze him, and then do double forward dash into back two, launch him, get a full combo. So you can really start to punish him quite hard when you use Frost, because he can't just willy-nilly chuck out the spear anymore. As you noticed, I did the Motaro 3 projectile thing. I've been messing around with a couple of Motaro's different assists. You know, I pretty much, prior to this set, I was only using the overhead, but during this recording session, I wanted to mess around with the low projectile and the multi-projectile, just to kind of see what the utility is with them. And the low projectile is very good, by the way. It's a really good thing for General Shao, because most of his axe strings have overheads. He only has one low in his axe stance and his unarmed stance, for that matter. So people just tend to stand block against you quite a lot, so having that low is very good. You know, it doesn't like lead to much reward on hit, it just causes a hard knockdown. But the good thing is, on block it's plus two, so you don't lose your turn and you don't get punished. Whereas with Frost, her forward cameo, it leads to much, much bigger reward on hit. But if it gets blocked, you get full punished. So I don't know. It's I like Frost for the new conversions, in, you know, you can do like axe buff conversions and stuff like that, but it's quite high risk, so I'm not too sure which I prefer right now. The multi-hitting projectile thing, it's it feels strong, but at the same time it feels really difficult to use. You know, it has like a 60 frame startup or something like that, so you can't like do a combo, end the combo with the cameo and then continue your pressure. It's too slow. And if Motaro gets hit out of the startup, you obviously lose the assist, and it costs your entire cameo bar, and it has a monumental recovery time. So I don't know, man. It's good when it works, but it's very costly. And unlike the teleport and the low projectile, you can easily screw yourself over. You can drop combos, you can mess up your pressure routes. I think with time and practice, you'll get, like me, for example, I think if I keep using it, I'll probably eventually get to a point where I'm more consistent with it and I don't muck up my own pressure and combos and stuff with it. But right now, it's a bit dodgy. You'll probably see in this set or maybe the next video, I'm not entirely sure. I definitely have some gameplay stuff with this where I muck up my combos quite often using that that assist. I think it, for me right now, I think it's a bit too risky in contrast to the reward I get for it. Ooh, I blocked it. Yeah, if I did up block there and block that and then hit like standing two, I think I could punish. Whereas if I don't do the up block, I think it's minus 3 on block, so I can't punish it, and then I have to engage in down 1 RPS, which I don't mind, I guess, you know. It's I'm definitely getting better at down 1 RPS, but really need to start taking those opportunities to do up block and punish where I can, especially in this matchup. Oh god. Oh, Johnny Cage. I've just literally, the day of recording this commentary, I've hit rank 5. With General Shao, so I'm one rank away now from my General Shao skin, which I'm very happy about. But I swear, man, throughout my entire run through rank 4 and my first match in rank 5, which I just played today, I must have fought like 80% Johnny Cage players. It's, oh my god, this character. I haven't studied his frame data too well yet, because he has a lot of like mix-ups, and his offense is quite layered, right? You can do overheads, he can do lows into overheads, he has a lot of plus frames, he can do a lot of stagger pressure and shimmies and stuff like that. His offense is way more complex than what Scorpion's is, so I'll study that for like the next video or the video after that, so I can do commentary on it. But God, this character, he's really hard for me to fight right now, and his mobility is so good, it's like second to none. It's kind of hard because, like, I don't know, like, I have more range than him for the most part. When I'm in axe stance, I have like really good like pokes, like standing 2, back 1, forward 4. But because of his movement speed, if I whiff anything, he can like shimmy really well. So if I whiff anything at all, he gets full punishes and he gets to go into his offense. And right now, because my English, my knowledge on how he structures his offense is kind of limited. I find it really difficult to get out. In this set, I'm just kind of taking guesses as to where I think he's minus, and, you know, just making reads when I think he's going to go for resets and stuff like that, and trying to, on reaction, block his overheads like that. Again, I think that's another situation where I really need to do up block so I can punish it rather than just do standing block, because I think, once again, it's safe. I'm not certain with that one. I haven't studied his frame data too well, but I know a lot of his stuff is safe. Yeah, look at that, man. Staggered pressure for days. Ugh. Yep, the low into the overhead. Yeah, I think, like, up block is something I really, really need to start using. I think it's going to be super useful for matchups like this, where you got characters with safe, kind of hard to react to overheads that are, you know, some you can combo from. Yeah, I just think it's going to be really useful, but it's hard wrapping my brain around using an up block. I'm just not used to it. He's using Jax as well, which is interesting. A lot of the Johnny Cage players I've been running into use Cyrax. Yeah, Cyrax. Cyrax must be the strongest cameo in the game because his... what's the word I'm looking for? His representation in the game is second to none. Everybody runs Cyrax, and I've seen some Johnny Cage players doing some very interesting pressure routes where they'll do the, like, a pressure out into the shadow kick. And I think the shadow kick is, what's it called? It's like unsafe on block, you can punish it, but they'll call in the, like, helicopter Cyrax assist to make it plus, and, you know, just run his offense and just do massive long pressure strings and mix-ups and stuff like that. Seems really good. Who else have I seen Johnny Cage players running? I saw Johnny Cage running a striker. Didn't really know much about it, honestly. I don't know if it was good or not. One thing I noticed, I was running Metaro in that matchup, and one thing I think I noticed is that Metaro doesn't seem to be able to reflect strikers' grenades. I think. I'm not certain on that, but I definitely tried a couple times and nothing happened, so I think it's another projectile where Metaro doesn't work too well against it. Nice. His reversal seems, like, really good as well. Yeah, oh god. I could have punished that, yeah. He seems to be able to cancel that. I definitely need to look into that, what's it called? Fatal Blow, because I keep getting gimmicked by it. But it's not my opponent, you know, it's not a fault on my opponent's part. It's just, you know, if I don't know it, they should gimmick me with it every single time until I learn it, so I'm gonna have to look into that. It's actually well played by them, in all honesty, using my limited matchup experience and capitalizing on it. But he does seem to be able to cancel it into a dash, but I wonder if there's like a window where he can cancel it, where, you know, like, you can option select it maybe. I don't know, I have to look into it. You know, like, you can delay your button so that if he cancels it, you hit him out of the cancel, but if he doesn't cancel it, you can still punish the full thing. I don't know. Have to give it a look. He's not using Jax too much, honestly, from what I can tell, although I haven't been watching the gameplay too much. Yeah, I was talking about his reversal, wasn't I? Yeah, his reversal seems pretty good. You can duck it, I think. I think it's a high you can duck it. I definitely know you can duck the standard version. I don't know if you can duck the enhanced version. But it travels full screen, so if I, like, knock him away with a string and then I choose not to apply pressure, he can still hit me on wake up with his reversal if I'm not careful. I played a Johnny Cage earlier today. That was the Johnny Cage I first played when I hit rank 5. And he was running Kano, and he was kind of doing the same thing with Kano as the other Johnny, as most Johnny Cages do with Jax, where he was using the knife toss to make his unsafe moves safe and to cover gaps in his strings. He was also using the knife toss in conjunction with his, what's a Majuja? His shadow kick, so he could do the shadow kick, cover the entire screen, and then I'd have to block the knives after. I didn't have to block the knives technically, right? Because you can duck the shadow kick and duck the knives and hit him with a low poke, like crouching 3 or crouching 4, crouching 1, stuff like that. But it took me quite a while. I'm embarrassed to admit this, but it took me quite a while to click on that I can just duck the shadow kick and duck the knives and then just hit him with a down 3 and just do that. It took me, like, I think 3 matches to figure out I could do that, unfortunately. But yeah, it was pretty clever, you know, using the knife toss to make stuff safe, and he was using the Kano ball for the same reason, to like frame trap after his strings and make stuff plus and fill gaps in his pressure sequences. It's quite clever. I don't really have stuff like that with General Shao. My pressure and mix-up route is very one-dimensional. It's not like layered like Johnny Cage. It's basically, if I hit you with the overhead, I do a combo. If I hit you with the low, I do a combo. If you block either one of them, my offense ends and then I engage in down one RPS. That's basically it. Dunk. Oh, that's unfortunate. But then again, I don't really think General Shao has a lot of strength when it comes to like multi-layered offense, unless you're running someone like Goro and you're using the up punch to get plus frames, then you can do some, you know, like resets and like really annoying pressure routes, but I don't think his base kit allows him to do a lot of stuff like that, unfortunately. His backdash is also pretty bad, so doing like a like button into backdash to try and make something whiff doesn't really work as well for General Shao as it does for Johnny. Yeah, see, I hit him with the Mataro multi-projectile and I completely mucked up the combo. Not used to it. And look how long that cameo bar's taken to regenerate. I've got half of it back now, but goddamn, that takes so long. And obviously, while the cameo is down, you don't get access to the low projectile for mix-ups and plus frames. You don't get access to the teleport for the overhead combos, so it's very costly, considering that if you don't get anything from it, you completely lose access to your cameo for like 10 seconds. So, meh, you know, I'm not too sure how much I like it or not. But next on my list, after Frost, I have recorded quite a few gameplays with Frost, so they're going to be in a couple of the upcoming videos. My next one is Kung Lao. I'm just going to bite the bullet and do Kung Lao because he seems like he's probably just flat out the best pick for General Shao. Now that I've messed around with, you know, a couple of the different cameos and I've been playing General Shao for, I don't know, a couple hundred matches at this point, I've kind of figured out what he needs. I think he needs a good low projectile. I think he needs a teleport. I think he benefits quite well from having a cameo reversal because his reversal's garbage. He benefits quite well from having a cameo assist that can extend combos because General Shao by himself doesn't do as much damage as some of the stronger characters in the game. So when you look at it from that context, everything I just said there, Kung Lao has. So yeah, I think he's overall the best pick, and then Mataro is probably like a counter pick for me. I'd probably run Mataro for characters who have projectiles or characters who like to spam projectiles, and I want a bit more, you know, counter zoning in my cameo. But I guess that's personal preference at that point, right? Like, if you're really comfortable dealing with projectiles, you know, and dodge, duck, dip, dive, dodging across the screen to get in on your opponent, then you don't really need Mataro, but I think he can be quite helpful for someone like me who has a bit of difficulty with it right now. Doink. Oh, that's terrible. Yeah, I really need to start varying up my offense. I keep doing that, like, down one into throws. I think down one's plus 12, so you can jail your opponent with a standing 2, and you can jail them with a standing 1 into a standing 2, which is a high into an overhead. You can't jail them with a back 1, because your back 1, even though it's a mid, it's 14 frames, so there's a 2 frame gap, but if they don't know there's a gap there, you can still use it, because the only option they really have to get through that gap is an armored reversal. No character in the game has a 2 frame normal, so they can't get through that. Oh yeah, look at this man, I just can't get out against Johnny. I really need to study his offense, figure out how it works. But yeah, you can't really like jail with the back one, but it's still useful if they don't know about the gap. So I really need to start using that a bit more. You know, the back one, the standing 1-2, the standing 2. One thing, I don't know why I do this in this game. I automatically assume going into the match that my opponent knows where the gaps in my strings are and knows that they can armor through them. So one thing I've been watching a couple like high level General Shao players, and one thing they'll do is they'll do standing 2-2 into the down forward heavy slash, which is the special move that heavy slash, that's Guilty Gear Strive, down forward 4, which is the special move that slams the axe into the ground. And I don't do that myself because I know there's a gap in between the standing two and the special move. And for some reason, I don't know why I do this in this game. I honestly don't know why. I assume that my opponent already knows the gap's there and they're going to armor through it. So that's why I don't do stuff like that, which is a really stupid idea. It's kind of funny because in Strive, I play Faust. And Faust has a lot of gimmicks and a lot of like weird stuff you can do. And I have multiple different like knowledge check things that I do to gauge whether or not if my opponent knows what the matchup is like and what the frame data is. You know, and that type of stuff allows me to kind of gauge what I can get away with. Like, can I do like really cheeky, super unsafe stuff? Can I use gimmicks that aren't real but they don't know about it and stuff like that? But in this game, I just automatically assume that people already know that stuff and I don't, you know, check them to see if they know it, which is really stupid on my part. I definitely need to implement that. Yeah, right there, I did the back three into the standing two, which is the low into the overhead. With Mataro or a low projectile, you can do the back three into the cameo assist, which is the low projectile, and do like a low low. So instead of low overhead, you get low low. And I've been using that quite a bit with Frost for quite a bit reward. Her combos are quite massive when you land that freeze. However, I have discovered a bit of a problem with it. The problem is that because the low is so rewarding, everybody just starts crouch blocking because now they have no reason to fear your overheads. Because with a Frost, you can't combo from forward 2, you can't combo from back 1-2, you can't combo from back 3-2, the low into the overhead. So when you run someone like Frost, because your overheads have very little reward and the low, you know, on hit gets you like 30%, something like that, they just start blocking low all the time. I played against, I think a Raiden. And I literally hit him with the overhead string 4 times in a row because he wouldn't stop crouch blocking. And I thought to myself, you know what? I've just hit him 4 times in a row with this low overhead. Surely on the 5th time, he's going to stand block it. And he didn't. So I did the low low, he blocked the freeze, and then he punished us. It's kind of funny. I actually think, this might sound a bit weird, I actually think having a less rewarding low might be more beneficial because it doesn't skewer the risk reward as much as what the Frost low does, so it makes the overhead more threatening by comparison. Snowball! Oh, that's so good. But having said that, doing like the axe buff combos with Frost is so good. I like them quite a bit. Not many characters allow General Shao to combo into his axe buff, unfortunately. Having said that though, I don't think the axe buff is super useful for the most part. I did some testing where I did like the same combo with the axe buff and the same combo without the axe buff. And the damage difference is only about 3%, so of course if you can get it right, there's no reason not to do it because more damage is more damage. But I think picking a character, like a cameo character, specifically so you can use the axe buff is kind of a bad idea. I don't think it's good enough right now to warrant, you know, prioritizing it. Doink. Yeah, see, right there, I didn't know this during the set either. I can just duck that and get a full punish. I don't need to block. Doink. I love that. The little backwalk into the back 2. I should really do backwalks into back 1 as well because that's it's a bit faster than the back 2 and has decent range, so it can be quite effective as well. Doink. Outranged it. Oh, yeah, I have no clue about that that funky dash thing. Really don't know. Hey, I blocked it. Damn. Doink, doink. And if you're wondering why I'm not using brutalities, oh, I actually thought I was going to kill that. If you're wondering why I'm not using, okay, I do get a brutality. If you're wondering why I'm not using throw brutalities, it's because I forgot them. I haven't memorized them yet. I literally have a note next to me right now with my brutalities on so I can remember them because I kept forgetting them. Donk, donk. Yeah, that's kind of my goal right now. Not my goal. My strategy with Johnny Cage right now is get a health lead and then turtle. Just walk away from him and then make him approaches. Try and make him whiff something and then whiff punish. Because I find if I try to approach Johnny, a lot of my normals whiff because of how good his backdash is and my spacing slash positioning right now isn't the best. I need to work on it. It's I keep like misspacing my standing two and my back three, and when they whiff, because of how good Johnny's mobility is, he just whiff punishes us all the time. So yeah, I get the health lead and then I just play keep away. Try and catch him, hitting a button. Try and catch him not blocking. Oh, why didn't I not punish that? I had like half a decade to recognize that whiff there. That was doo-doo brain on my part. Tried something cheeky. It's not real though. Oh, he mucked up. Yeah, see, that's my entire game plan right now with Johnny. Make him whiff crap and then punish. I dropped that deliberately there, I think, for the brutality, but that might have not been on purpose. I can't remember. Is that the end? Yeah, that's the end. I think that's the end of this video. So I hope you enjoyed, and thanks for watching.